This section is designed to help you comprehend the implementation of raster data models in GIS applications. Raster data models are extensively used in applications beyond Geographic Information System, GIS. If you've worked with digital photographs, you're likely familiar with this data model. Common file formats such as JPEG, BMP, and TIFF are built on the raster data model, referred to Chapter 5, Section 5.3, File Formats. Take a look at any digital image and zoom in. You'll observe it's made up of small square pixels. Each uniquely colored pixel combines to create a comprehensive image when viewed in entirety. Raster technology is also the foundation of all liquid crystal display LCD computer monitors, composed of a fixed number of pixel rows and columns. The origins of this technology can be traced back to the pointillism technique developed by neo-impressionist artist Georges Seurat in the 1880s, which uses small monochromatic dots of ink that combine to form a larger image. By extension, you could view your raster dataset creations as works of art. A raster data model comprises interconnected rows and columns of equally sized pixels to form a flat surface. These pixels are the building blocks for points, lines, areas, networks, and surfaces. While pixels can be triangles, hexagons, or octagons, square pixels are the simplest geometric form to work with. Consequently, most raster GIS data are built on the square pixel. These squares typically transform into variously dimensioned rectangles when the data model is shifted from one projection to another. The raster data model, due to its reliance on a uniform series of square pixels, is commonly referred to as a grid-based system. Typically, a single data value is assigned to each grid cell, representing a spatial phenomenon at a specific location. The raster graphic can alternatively reference a database management system wherein attribute tables can be used to associate multiple data values with each pixel. As computer technology advances, this method has become increasingly viable. However, the raster model averages all values within a given pixel to produce a single value. Therefore, the larger the area covered per pixel, the less accurate the associated data values. The area covered by each pixel determines the spatial resolution of the derived raster model. Thus, a raster model with pixels representing 10 million by 10 million in the real world would have a spatial resolution of 10 million, and so forth. It's important to strike a balance when determining raster resolution, since excessively coarse pixel resolution may lead to data loss, while overly fine pixel resolution can result in larger file sizes and increased computer processing requirements. Effective pixel resolution takes both the map scale and the minimum mapping unit of the other GIS data into account. Images using the raster data model must display several properties. Firstly, each pixel must hold at least one value, even if the data value is zero. Secondly, a cell can hold any alphanumeric index that represents an attribute, translating to a predetermined rule in qualitative datasets. The third property is that points and lines tend to shift to the center of the cell, implying that the minimum width for any line feature must be one cell, regardless of the feature's actual width.